Hello, welcome back to my channel. First of all, I would like to take a moment and say thank you to each and everyone who have appreciated me for my first video. Thank you so much, guys. Without your appreciation, I wouldn't have been able to do this video. So I'm really encouraged by you all, and I'm really, really grateful that you took your time out, sat there and watched my video. I really love you all. Thank you. Many friends in life, okay, single guy friends, and they always come up to me and they're like, please get me a girl, please get me a girl. And I'm like, you are so nice, why don't you get a girl? And after that, when talking to them, I realized that in this world, guys are divided into two different categories. One is good, one is bad. Now for me, an ideal man is the one who understands the fine line between the two and works on that. Number one, we women, we are really dumb. I have put this as the first point because girls out there and me, we both can relate to this. Even after getting our hearts been broken for millions of times and swearing that we'll never go and date such type of guy again a gazillion of times, still we end up with that type of man. And some of us are so lucky, they even go and marry these guys. And now, those a-holes are breeding new a-holes just to continue their legacy. Number two, the bad guys are hot. Have you ever met a bad guy who is not either hot or charming? I have not. And whenever you see a girl describing her cute, nice friend, she always says, "Aww, he's so cute." And whenever she describes the bad guy crush, she always goes like, "Oh, so hot." Actually, these bad guys do a lot of bad things and they get away with it. And they couldn't have done that if they were not so handsome. No. Before you get all judgmental, I am not categorizing handsome guys being bad guys. But the handsome guys who are good guys, they're you. You guys are in our dreams. We're actually searching you with our telescope everywhere. Still can't find. So this point is on you guys, because just because you guys are nowhere around us, we have to settle for the bad guys. Number three, nice guys are boring. Now this is the trick and the most common reason why nice boys don't end up getting the girl. You guys are not a risk takers. You guys don't know how to take risks, or either that or you don't want to take risks. You always play safe. Playing safe is a very good quality, and for that reason we go up to you guys for life's critical, good, stable decisions. But you make a very bad boyfriend because you're too predictable and boring. We women want guys who are aggressive, powerful, and they are so daring in their actions. We want spices, masala in our life. So this kind of challenges which we women want in our life is sadly fulfilled by the bad guys. So that's another reason. Number four, nice guys are dreamers. Nice guys constantly dream about that future where they'll have a perfect love life, but in present they really don't do anything to make that future better. Nice guys always stay in their comfort zone and try and live in their fantasy world, and when that bubble pops, they suffer. It's not that nice guys don't get girls, they do get girls. They do get nice girls, but they don't get into a relationship with them because they live in their hope that one day their niceness will get them the girl of their dreams, who by the way has kept them in her friends and position since they met. Dream on, bro. You're not getting her. Number five, the inability to say no. Well, guys, we love that you say yes to all our demands and get on board with all our tantrums. We actually love them. But does your dictionary completely lacks the word no? कहाँ से खरीदे सब बकवास dictionary? I know you guys are too nice to say a no, but trust me, agreeing to disagree is a healthy component of any relationship. अगर झगड़ा ही नहीं होगा तो प्यार कैसे बढ़ेगा? And I kept the best for the last. The fear of rejection. Biggest flaw in any nice guy's life is the fear of rejection. And that fear of rejection stops them from making the first move and lands them in the friend zone position for the rest of their life. And then they cream about life not being perfect, life not being fair. Dude, life is anyway not perfect, life is not fair. But if you don't try, life will never be fair for you. So guys, if you love some girl, just go up to her and tell her that you love her. Before she comes up to you complaining about another bad boy, whom by the way she has fallen in love with again. So man up and tell her the truth. Confess to her. Tell her you love her. Make her feel special. Make her feel that she is unlike all the other female friends in your life. And if she rejects, accept it. Be calm and accept the fact that she has rejected you and move on in your life. But never, never compromise to be in the friend zone position, because friend, that position is not a happy place to be. To wrap the whole video up, there is no guy who is perfect. There is a good or bad guy's characteristic on each one of us. So you be the judge and decide which one is good for you, which one is good for the situation. And bottom line of the whole thing, nice guy syndrome can kill you or your relationship. So you choose what is good for you. Don't be a doormat for the rest of your life. That was the end of the video, and if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel and comment below and let me know how many of you have been in a friendzone position. Until we meet next, be a hot mess, buy your favorite dress, but do not settle for less.